Hey Karan, how are you? Long time. Welcome to India TV Forum.
Thank you so much. It's been a long time, but it's just that you've been calling me so many times, but I've been just so busy.
Yes, I know, and we have so many. You've been away, and then I was away, and anyway, good. So whatever, all's well that ends well. Good that we got in touch today with you, and everything I always believe happens for a purpose. So I think this time is really nice to get to know you. It's a friendship week and a friendship day as well. So we would like to wish you, on behalf of India TV Forum, a very happy friendship day.
Thank you so much, and the same to you guys as well.
And so what are your plans? What have you been doing? Any plans for this day?
Nothing as such. Whenever I'm in Mumbai, whenever I'm not working, it's like a friendship day every day for us. Yeah, we're always together. We only go home to sleep, and the rest of the time we're all together.
Okay.
I guess I'm gonna be with my friends, and that's what's more important.
Right. And so you've been catching up with some films right here, and you forced some friends to Harry Potter.
Yeah, that was in Punjab. How do you know
see, खबर रखते हैं हम.
that? I have this friend in Jalandhar, Punjab, so he's quite a film maniac, you can say. He knows everything. He's like the encyclopedia of all Hindi, Punjabi and Hollywood films. So, me and him really wanted to catch up with Harry Potter, the last film that was, so. And so many answers, I've been following Harry Potter since that time. I mean, I haven't been reading the books, but I've been watching all the movies. So we were all really excited to watch this film. And, there was nobody. And my Punjab friends are like really chilled, and they're not the type who enjoy Harry Potter. So I dragged them along, and they were like almost about to kill me. They were like, "We don't want to watch this film. Why are we here? Why are you watching Harry Potter?" And like, "Dude, it's Harry Potter. Harry Potter is like," and they're like, "Karan, you're 26. Get over it." I'm like, I mean, Harry Potter's been out since what, I was 17, 18, whatever. I mean, how many years it's been there? So it's like kind of there. We're curious, Yeah, I mean, I'm not as excited that I would be for the first film, but yeah, I mean, there's the excitement still there. And I mean, I want to be a kid all my life. Yeah. What's the use of growing up? I mean, I don't get it.
Yeah, I agree with you completely on that. It is, what they say, if you don't mind, it doesn't matter what's in the age.
I don't give care too much about the age.
Yeah, and I think so. I agree with you. Harry Potter is just not meant for kids. I mean, I know so many adults who are so crazy waiting for the book to come out and then for the
Yeah,
film
ma'am,
to be released.
one of those crazy adults.
So anyway, so that's good to know. And also, Karan, I would like to take this opportunity to ask you to wish all your fans who follow the Islamic faith, it's the holy month of Ramadan. So if you could please.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, to all the people who are, religiously taking fast and everything, it's like a big thing. I couldn't even imagine doing it. So I wish you all the best and good luck. I think it's a big ordeal for me to keep fast like this. So many of our fans are basically Ramadan Kareem is what I want to say, and all the best, and we wish you all the happiness in life. That's what's most important.
Yes, I think so, and I think you said it and put it out very well. And so, Karan, going on to some fun things. I know you are a gizmo freak, or especially a telephone gadget freak. So now I understand you own two of the competing phones, both the BlackBerry and the iPhone. So which one is your favorite?
I think you cannot, compare an iPhone with a BlackBerry or a BlackBerry with an iPhone. They're
Okay,
two
you
different
can't compare
phones.
BlackBerries with apples, let's say that.
Yeah, you cannot. Yeah, they're two different fruits. They're two. Yeah, so it's like, I mean, iPhone is iPhone. iPhone is like the god of all phones. But BlackBerry is like, the god of all social networking. Yeah, BBM is like a big thing. The entire industry is on it. All my friends are on it. Like, so many of my friends who settled in probably, UK, Canada, Australia even. It's very difficult to, stay in touch with them, even if you're on Facebook, because people like me are hardly on Facebook, I go there, just update my status on my page, talk to a few fans, and I come back. So I don't have time for all this.
Right.
But so you know, you don't get to speak to them. You know, 6 months go by and you haven't spoken to them. But then, you know, after I got the BB, everybody's on my list, and whenever you think about them, it's just a click away. You know, just take out their phone, say hi, and you know.
Right.
So it's kind of got me together to, you know, so many people. And then, you know, as I said, the entire industry is on BBM, so everything is happening here. You know, you can talk about work, you can talk about anything. Yeah? I mean, all the. In fact, you know, everything happening in Bombay is going on BBM as well. There are groups. You even come to know where there are cops. So you've got to be careful while driving from there. You get to know where the best parties are happening, whatever you like. Like, I like retro music a lot. So I'm updated with all things happening on retro. And so many social causes, like, you know, charity events are going on, you know, some walks are going, candlelight marches are going on. So you come to know about all these things on BBM. You know,
right.
I have so many people. You're, like, connected through your phone, you know. Facebook is now, I think, I don't have the patience for Facebook.
Yeah, I think everything goes, has its own phases. And then, like, yeah, at one point when the Facebook actually started was a good thing. And, yeah, it is getting, everyone is going to the same phase now. Yeah.
If you have a laptop and you have 1 hour every day to devote, I think then Facebook is pretty good.
Mm-mm.
But BBM is short. You know, you put a picture, you put a status, and everybody's on your list. You know what's going on with your friends, your family.
Mm-mm.
Like, my family's on BBM, my friends are on BBM, my know, Punjab friends are on BBM, my work people are on BBM.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of cool because then you get, you know, stay connected with all the people that, you know, really mean to you. And Facebook is something else. You have thousands of people on Facebook, you can't keep a track, you know, but BBM is connected to 300 people.
Think so. I agree with you. And so I think you should become a brand ambassador for them now, Karan, and then promote them even more. So we should get in touch with them and say, do this here. They're getting free publicity.
I'm the kind of big person who cannot, you know, like, if I'm using my BlackBerry, I am equally using my iPhone. The gaming on iPhone, you know, the net on iPhone, you know, the processing speed and everything. Like, if you're a gizmo freak, you have to have an iPhone.
Mm-mm.
But, you know, work, you need a BB. So I carry both. I mean, it's quite disgusting for me to carry two phones.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I keep my iPhone with me whenever because, you know, the music on iPhone is much better. The graphics on iPhone is much better.
Yes.
Just gaming is far, far, far better than, you know, on BB. So I think it's like, unless, you know, you get a phone which has both of these options, till then you, you know, carry two phones.
Yes, I agree with you. I know that. And both of them are fairly, like, big and chunky as well. So it's not easy. But, I think you can. I'm sure very soon they'll come out with something where you can use both the features on one instrument.
If iPhone comes up with, you know, integration with BBM, I would not carry the BBM. It's too much for me. I think an iPhone with the BBM integration is, like, my dream. If it comes through, I'd, you know, do something about it.
That is true, that is true. So, and okay, so I think, I agree, because I think the advert that comes out for an iPhone is also very classy. It says, if you have an iPhone, you have one. If you don't, you don't. It's just simple.
It's true. There's so many people who are on BBM who ask me, who are on BBU, who ask me, you know, what should be an iPhone? And you use it.
Yeah.
And then you know what an iPhone is. And it's pretty true. You have an iPhone or you don't have an iPhone. That's pretty true. You can have it or you don't.
So that's what I know. That's right. Yeah, the interface and I think what the Apple guys do, the Mac people, everything,
Apple,
even your laptop.
It's very technologically very advanced. The iPhone is quite advanced.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So anyway, so good. And otherwise, what else, Karan, what's been happening?
Nothing, just been chilling, working out, you know, getting ready for my next project.
Oh, good. Is something in the pipeline?
Well, I have a lot of shows. I mean, I've refused 7 shows, you know, 7 mainstream shows, because, you know, TV gets really tiring for me, you know. I kind of want a break from it.
Yeah.
And I might do a film by the end of this month, August 10 sometime. So things are in there, you know.
Yeah.
It's a nice, it's not those big films, it's a nice small film.
Yeah, I think they have they have a far wider reach these days, these small films. I don't know if you heard of this film, Udaan.
Udaan was a brilliant film. I was supposed to do Shaitaan as well. Shaitaan didn't work out because of my dates with Kitni 2. And, you know, I was quite upset about not being a part of that movie. It was like a big movie. I hope you've heard of it.
Yeah.
I was supposed to play Casey's role in that. So it was quite a big opportunity for me. But I guess everything happens, like, there's a time for everything.
Yeah.
So now the kind of film that I'm looking at it, you know, are basically intelligent films, you know, catering to maybe not the masses, but to a very limited audience. And, you know, it's fun to be a part of such films.
I agree with you. Yeah, I think the small budget.
I don't have the time anymore to do a daily soap, because daily soap takes out every bracket of, you know, millisecond that you have in your life. And it's like a big commitment, you know.
Yes.
But film is not like that. Like, I have my own business that I have to run, and my dad, like, really needs me right now. So I think I'm going to be choosing a profession now which is going to give me time. You know how films are, you shoot for 15-20 days, then you have another 10 days off.
Yes.
Then you have another 1 month schedule, then you have another 10 days off. And then, you know, I mean, acting is always, it's not been a very, it's not been a profession for me, it's more of a passion. So I think I'm going to be working on my business more, and trying to fit in, you know, I'll try to fit in films if I can.
Yeah, I think I can totally understand and relate to what you're saying. I think the daily soaps can be quite, they zap you out of every bit of energy, I suppose.
Yeah, because, you know, it's a daily soap. You need to be shooting every day. There are no holidays. There are no, you know, you can't say that, okay, I'm available for 15 days and then I'm off for 10 days. It's not possible in a daily soap, especially if you're the lead, you know. If you're some other character, you can adjust dates and everything. But if you're playing a lead, then there is no way that you can take out 7 to 8 days every month for your work. And my work is all in Punjab. I need to travel. So I think I'm going to be focusing on my work, because it's almost been 3 years that I've been in the industry, and I've had my piece of, you know, piece of cake that I really wanted. And now I think I need to focus. I'm already 26. I need to focus. I need to decide what I need to do in life. So.
Yeah, I think it gave you the recognition that you wanted, and today you are such a well-known name in the industry and in the field, and with so much of global fan following. So I think, yeah, everything, as you said, happens for a purpose. And we only wish,
you know, if I could, you know, I would always want to keep acting. Like, you know, it's a passion that I realized quite late in my life. Thanks to Ekta Kapoor. But yeah, I mean, you know, things most important are my family. So I need to, you know, devote time there.
So yeah,
I can always come back to acting.
Of course, yes. So. Yeah, and as I was saying, that I hope we continue to see you. Or I mean, at the end of the day, you have to pursue your dreams and what your forte and where you're most comfortable with and are in.
Well, I'm most comfortable acting, but you know, things are not always what you how you want them to be.
Yes. So
it's just that I'm taking a break from daily soaps.
Okay. So, but then you will keep shuttling between Bombay and Punjab, right?
Definitely.
So that's good. And
it's just that I'm not ready for a full 1 year commitment on any show right now, because if I was 24, I would have taken up another show.
Yeah.
But unfortunately, I'm not. So I need to, you know, decide what I
I think
gonna be away from the small screen at least for a while.
Yeah, and I think I've always liked your very honest approach to everything, Karan. That's what I think I really enjoy talking to you about. And you're very upfront. You're very forthright. No beating around the bush. You know, and you state your facts and your figures very clearly. And I think that's what is going to take you places. Actually,
I hope so. Inshallah.
And and then any song you would like to dedicate to all your fans?
A song? I think it's Friendship Week, so there's a song called Yaro Dosti. Some song. It's a very sweet song about friends.
Okay. And would you like to hum or sing on that?
I don't know the words. If I knew, I would have definitely. Okay. But it's a very sweet song.
Okay. So fine. So Yaro Dosti, out to you, Karan, and on behalf of you as well as from you to all of us.
Definitely.
And thank you so much for doing this for us, and we will continue to keep in touch. And thanks once again for, on behalf of India TV Forum, I will send you the link of the interview to you as well, to put it up
anytime,
on your wall.
Anytime.
Okay.
Anytime. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. And you have a lovely day and a lovely weekend as well.
You too.
Bye-bye. Take care. Oh.
DJ Punkage.